I just said this thing, like, we have this idea that Muslim men can say, I divorce you. You can go home and tell your wife. You could call her on Skype. We could call her right now. And you can, she's sleeping, I know. But you could say, I divorce you three times and, like, turn in a circle. I don't know what you'd do, and you'd be divorced.
First of all, I will be never.
Yeah. She would kill you, right?
No, I wouldn't kill you because I love her. And I love my family. Second, you know, yes, this is a topic in Islam that the key of divorce in the hand of, you know, the husband. So anytime he can use this is the right. So many people thinking that this is a discrimination. Yes, if you see this, yeah, this is a discrimination because this is in my hand. So I can use this weapons anytime, anywhere. But in reality, in Islam, in fiqhs, there is some right for the woman as well, which is we call separation. It's the same.
Separation.
Same, you know, the divorce. But the different thing is that the separation is the wife, the woman should be called asking for the court and judge. And the divorce just in the hand of, you know, the husband. So according to the fiqh, the woman can asking for this four reasons, the separations. The forced damaging or discriminations, like torturing, like that.
Or just being mean, yeah.
The second, you know, the problem, the health problem, like, he cannot, you know, just make a family for future.
Have sex. Have intercourse.
The third one is, you know, the husband cannot provide the basic life.
Needs.
Yeah, needs like house, food, like that. The fourth one is disappear. Like the husband disappear. No any message. No any. You know, call, phone, nothings. Mm-hmm. So after 3 years, she can, you know, asking for the court for the divorce. There is another also kind of divorce, which is the key is in the hand of the wife and the girls, which we call, you know, like khola in Arabic, in khola. Khola means that the wife asking for the husband, I can pay you some money, or the money that you want to give me, it's up to you now. I don't need this money. Please.
The money that you promised. Yeah, you
yeah.
Would give
the promise.
Me.
Yes.
We don't need that. Yes, I just want a divorce.
Just divorce.
And so she can get divorced.
Yeah. This is like. Khola, we call khola.
So it's not that different.
Yeah. So if when you see the balance of the poverties, the balance of poverty of the woman are so high because she can ask in any way for the divorce and for the separations.
So in Afghanistan, a man can say, you could say to your wife, I want a divorce, but that doesn't mean you're going to get a divorce.
No.
And if you do, your wife and your two children, you have to... They receive your estate. I mean, you have to take care of them.
So what's the responsibility of the husband of the divorce? So he should be paid like 6 months all the needs of the wife first. The second, he should be take care of the child up to 16 or 18 years old, all the needs. At the meantime, he should be paid the money that he promised during of the wedding for the wife.
Yeah.
At the last one, which is the inheritance, as you know, inheritance should be, you know, the things that be divided with the family and the case and all.
So according to this, in what you're using in Afghan law, and this is what's important, because here's the guy who's participating in writing this, calling it Sharia. And here we are on the other side of the world thinking, hearing these ideas about Sharia, and we have no idea what it means. We have our politicians and our leaders talking about Sharia and backwards Muslims, and we need to go, and I'm going to show you some of these folks. And here, what you're saying is, look, this is actually really not very complex. And when we walk down through some things, I think, wow, there's so many ways in which it's, in a legal sense, Muslims, you have more rights. Look, in the United States, if a spouse goes missing, if I go missing, just disappear, just like that. And then my wife, before she can start spending my money, before she can sell her house, before she can really take control of all of my things, all of our things, she has to wait a certain number of years. Same in Afghanistan. If Rafi just goes missing, if he just never goes home, his wife has, she can't assume that he's dead. She has to just wait a certain number of years. In Afghanistan, that number of years is 4. And we had a conversation this afternoon with a former judge from the state of Ohio. And we said, hey, how many years does the spouse have to wait in Ohio? And he said, 7. So in Afghanistan, you have to wait 4 years. In Ohio, you have to wait 7 years before you can actually spend the estate. And I thought, wow, we were saying like, and he was laughing because he couldn't believe that it would be less years in Afghanistan than in Ohio. And this is the idea. We just have all these, this sense that things are backwards and you all need to get your act together and one thing after another.